ونستهديه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، خير نبي اصطفاه ورحمة للعالمين أرسله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، عندما نتحدث عن رمضان لا نتحدث فقط عن الجانب الروحي فيه، فلا نتحدث عن التراويح ولا عن قراءة القرآن ولا عن الصدقات ولا عن قيام الليل فقط، بل يأخذنا الحديث وتأخذنا الذاكرة عن الفتوحات التي جرت في شهر رمضان المبارك، وهذا يدفعنا إلى التفكير عن مدى ثقة القوم أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بربهم، وما هذه القوة التي جعلت هؤلاء القوم يخوضون المعارك للدفاع عن دين الله وعن أمتهم، ويخوضون معارك لقمة العيش وضنك الحياة، فلا صعوبة الحياة منعتهم من إقام شعائر الله، ولا التضاريس ولا الجغرافيا حالت بينهم وبين الهدف الذي ارتضوه لأنفسهم، فهم ما فهموا من رمضان أنه وقت الموائد، ولا فهموا أن رمضان هو وقت السهر، بل كان جهدهم في رمضان يضاعف جهدهم في الأوقات في غير رمضان، ففي الليل قياما لله رهبانا وفي النهار فرسانا، لأنهم فهموا عن الله مرادا وفهموا الحكمة من وجودهم في هذا الكون. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, when we speak about Ramadan, we don't only speak about the spiritual side of it. We don't only talk about the Taraweeh or the recitation of the Quran, about the charity, about being kind to your relative and to your ummah, but we only speak about the physical achievements that our grandfathers, the first generation, the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, were able to achieve during the month of Ramadan. History tells us that the Battle of Badr, Fath Makkah, Ma'arakat al-Qadisiyah, the conquest of Mecca, the Battle of the Qadisiyah, the conquest of Spain, Fath al-Andalus, the Battle of the Zallaqa, معركة الزلاقة، معركة حطين، معركة عين جالوت، all took place in the month of Ramadan. You may say to me, there is no way for us to meet their level of effort. But in reality, they are human like us, with the limitation of ability. But the only
different between us and them. They use their ability up to the top level. And we only manage to use our ability at the bare minimum. They understood the revelation of Allah Azza wa Jal. And what is it that Allah Azza wa Jal wanted from them? They understood the reason behind their existence. So they used the time wisely and accordingly. But when you look at us, and especially if you try to compare our achievements to theirs, we realize that we are a joke. The month of Ramadan, according to us, it's only about food and drink, spending the night and shisha, sleeping during the day, and I'm not talking about community wiser. I'm talking about the ummah in general. The month of Ramadan, and especially in the Middle East, it's a month of lack of production. If you want to do something, you delay the hard work until the month, till the end of Ramadan. People, they spend the most of the night sleeping or waking up, watching movie, and most of the day are sleeping. They wake up shortly before or be right before the sunset. The month of Ramadan, only about food and drink. They begin the month of Ramadan 100 pounds and they end up 200 pounds by the end of Ramadan. This wasn't the case of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قَرَأُوا التَّنزِيلِ وَفَهِمُوا مُرَادَ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنَّنَا نَقْرَأُ التَّنزِيلِ وَلَا نَكَادُ نَفْقَهُ مَا يُرِيدُهُ اللَّهُ مِنَّا. They were able to understand the revelation of Allah and the commandments of their Lord. So they used their time accordingly. They were able to learn from their mistake and adjust accordingly again. They learned in the Quran al-Kareem the six means of success. And Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed the six means of success right after the Battle of Badr. And we know the Battle of Badr was the first battle that the Muslim must serve. Right after the battle, they faced a very strange situation. The spoil of war, al-ghanam. Everyone began to look for his best interest. What is it that he can possibly gain? Everyone believed that he deserved more than his brother. It is a very strange situation. There is no revelation in the Quran to solve this dispute. So quickly Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed Surah Al-Anfal. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ قُلِ الْأَنْفَالُ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. They ask you about the spoil of war. Tell them the spoil of war, the ruling of the spoil of war, belongs to Allah and His Messenger. In the same surah, Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed the six means of success. If you're looking to be successful in this worldly life and the hereafter, you must pay attention to the conditions of success. facing the challenge. This is number one. Your ability to stand firm while you are facing the challenge. Do not lose your identity. Do not lose your focus. Whether you are facing financial challenge or economical challenge or educational challenge, whether you are dealing with your relatives, you're dealing with your ummah, you're dealing with your health, stand firm. قدرتك على الوقوف على الحق في وجه الصعاب ولله دره ابن القيم عندما قال كن على طريق الحق ولا تهتم بقلة السالكين وإياك وطريق الباطل ولا تغتر بكثرة الهالكين. ابن القيم mentioned a very beautiful statement. He said, be on the straight path of Allah, even if you're alone. And do not take the road of falsehood. And do not be deceived by the number of those who take that road. The month of Ramadan teaches us how to be firm, how to stand firm while we are facing the challenges. We do whatever is good and right to do, regardless if the whole nation are doing it or not. We learn through the Siyam that truth, you must stand up for the truth even if you are alone. We fast because Allah Azza wa Jal called us to fast. And I really couldn't care less if the half of the humanity or the rest of the humanity are fasting or not. As long as I'm fulfilling my role. In the other, the month of Ramadan, we only believe that you must stick with the majority of the ummah. And especially when the mashayikh speak about unity, they say about being with the majority. And this is wrong. The majority never on the straight path of Allah. Never. Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned in the Quran only the minority of the population are of the straight path of Allah. وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ. Unity in the definition of Islam means a group of people who are fulfilling the commandment of Allah, even if they were minority. So during the month of Ramadan, we learn to stick with the minority who are fulfilling the role. And we ignore the majority if they are ignoring the call of Allah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِيَةً فَاثْبُتُوا. This is هذا الرقم الواحد من قوانين النجاة. والشرط الثاني واذكروا الله كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا لقيتم فئة فاثبتوا واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون. Remember Allah by your tongue, by your hand, by your eye, by your ear. من ذكر الله عز وجل في ملئه ذكره الله في ملأ خير منه. إذا دعتك نفسك إلى ريبة فقل لها بأن الله حاضر. فقل لها بأن الله حاضر. The second condition, to remember Allah. Third, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا. Do not defer, so you lose your honor. في غزوة بدر عندما اختلف صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بأمر الغنائم قال الله عز وجل لهم فاتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم. ذات بينكم أصابه شرف. ذات بينكم تحطم. ذات بينكم ما ينبغي له أن يهدم. بذات البين تنجح. ليس بالمال. When the Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam disputed about the spoil of war, the first thing that Allah Azza wa Jalla told them to do, fear Allah and maintain your relation with each other. Know that success, it only can be achieved when you maintain your relation with your community, with yourself, with your relatives. Money cannot make you a legacy, but your relative can. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا. And we all heard what happened in the Middle East in the past 3-4 days. That lucky that the Saudi government, Emirat, Masr, Bahrain, they decide to do against Qatar. يا أصحاب العباءات اتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم. يا أصحاب العقال ذات بينكم أصابه شرخ. ذات بينكم تهدم. ذات بينكم تحطم. وعلى ماذا؟ أمشي على ورق الخريطة خائفا. أمشي على ورق الخريطة خائفا. فعلى الخريطة كلنا أعناق. أتكلم الفصحى. hand of Allah. They are shame. And they are real embarrassment for us. I wish that they can unite themselves against their enemy. But all we can do, we show our effort, our strength against our own brothers. وَظُلْمُ ذَوِي الْقُرْبَى أَشَدُّ مَرَارَةً عَلَى الْمَرْءِ مِنْ وَقْعِ الْحُسَامِ الْمُهَنَّدِ. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ بَطَرًا. Number 6. Do not be like all those who march out to show people their strength. هل تشاهدون الإعلام العربي الفاجر؟ Do you watch the Middle East or the Arab media in general these days? There is show been broadcasting through the NBC called Ramiz Dakh Al Arab, Ramiz Under the Ground. What they do, they search for the famous actors. They call them over to Abu Dhabi. They pay for their travel. 5-star hotel. What happened? They take him in a road in the desert. And it's a trick. It's a trick. And finally they arrive at a moving sand where the actor actually go in his car right in the sand. And after that he will come out of the sand full of dust, screaming, yelling, cursing this movie and those who are behind the movie. And in the end they paid him $100,000. At the same time, NBC controlled many of media, many of stations, many of TV. One of them called Al-Hadath. Al-Hadath broadcast the situation of people in Iraq. When they made an interview with one of them, who managed to escape from the danger of Al-Mosul, when they asked him about what's happened in the Mosul, he said, I have to leave my wife behind. She was shot. I couldn't carry her. I want to escape with my children. So I left my wife lying down, bleeding to death on the road there. Do we really need to spend $1,000 or millions of dollars to make people laugh? Ramiz Under the Ground, they spend millions of dollars just to put a smile on the face of the followers or the viewers. But we can spend half of the money to put a smile on the Syrian refugee or the Iraqi refugee. سبيل الله. This is the situation of our ummah. This is the situation during the month of Ramadan. Our media is the worst media on the face of the planet. They did not exist to support the cause of their ummah. But they are there to support the cause of their leaders. Poverty in Lebanon. Poverty in Syria. Poverty in Iran. Afghanistan, Pakistan, Sudan, Ethiopia, Libya, Yemen, even in the Indian Saudi itself. When you just travel away from the haram and then you realize the reality of that country.
Why?
And they don't know the killer. So the scholar said, there's a chance that he screamed upon someone to help him out and they failed to help him. حد القسامة عندما يقتل رجل في فلاة ولا يعلم قاتله. الخليفة يأتي بخمسين رجل يقسمون بالله خمسين يمين أنهم ما قتلوه ولا علم له قاتل. وبعد هذا يدفعون ديته. قال أهل العلم لماذا؟ قال ربما صرخ عليهم طالبا النصرة فقصروا في نصرته. كم رجلا يموت في البلاد العربية والأمة أجمعها تقصر في نصرتهم. قوانين الله لا تتخلف. لا تتخلف. وستعلمون ونعلم ويعلم غيرنا أن الله عز وجل غالب على أمره ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. أقول هذا القول وأستغفر الله ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الفوز المستقيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. Dear respected brothers and sisters, tonight, inshallah, there is a fundraising dinner to purchase a masjid in downtown under demand of ISC. You may say to me, and next week, inshallah, there will be another fundraising for the Salam Center to pay off the remaining of the amount owing under the city. You may say to me, you know what, masjid, you don't want to support it, or we have enough facilities. Wallahi, and the brothers who are involved with me to find a place, they knew how hard for you to find a place and to call it worship place. No one wants to deal with us as a Muslim. No one. And this is a situation of us. Now, could you imagine what's going to happen for our children in the future? The city growing very big, and our facility are the same. It is our duty and your duty as a Muslim to participate in purchasing a place called Masjid. Wallahi, people will never recognize you or notice you after your death by what you left for your children. But you will be remembered by your positive contribution to your society. Establishing or purchasing masjid, it's the responsibility of every individual. Wallahi, if we remain the same as we are right now, fighting with each other, refusing to help one another, our children, they will face that huge struggling in the near future. There is no organization can actually claim that they can serve the community and their own. Our community is too big to be served by one organization. But we really acknowledge the effort that most of the Muslim committee are doing to serve their community. Now we want to support the ISC and MAC for their purchasing the masjid. Inshallah, in the future, if the MCC, the Muslim Council of Governing, decided to build a masjid, we will be there to support them. Because in the end, the masjid remains. We all will be replaced. tomorrow will be another one. But the community remains here. It is our duty to find the facility for ourselves and for our youth. Let's stop labeling each other with different labels. Whoever wants to serve the community by a masjid, wallahi, we will be there to support him. Regardless of his identity or his nationality. I don't want people to say, well, this is the Pakistani brother, we don't want to support him, or the Lebanese brother, we don't want to support him. There is no membership to enter any masjid. If you pray in the Northwest, you can enter the Rajdan Center. And no one stops you from entering. If you are praying in the Northwest, you can enter As-Salamu Salam. No one can stop you from entering. Or Akam Jum'ah. There is no membership. We need to understand that building masajid is the responsibility of every individual. Our fathers, they were able to buy the Southwest. Some of our brothers, they were able to buy, alhamdulillah, Akram Jum'ah. But subhanAllah, recently, looks like we began to fight with each other and we forgot that our community are growing so big and we need to accommodate everyone. So alhamdulillah, Salam Center was bursting. Now I see, please have your way out. I'm not expecting you to donate now. But please, give me your name and number that you are willing to pay to participate in building this masjid. In building this masjid in downtown. We need to support it. Part of your zakat. Part of your zakat. Wallahi, لأن يذكر الله عز وجل في ذلك المسجد خير لك من الدنيا وما فيها. So we need to participate in this. Please, brother. I'm not expecting everyone to go to the dinner tonight or to the iftar, but I'm expecting many brothers of you to give me your name, your number, and inshallah, me and Sheikh Hassan Shibani will visit you after this gathering, inshallah, after this event. We're going to visit every or many of you, inshallah, please, do not let us down. Sheikh Hassan and myself, inshallah, we're working hard to collect 1.5 million to finalize the deal. I'm sure there's another 2 million for the Maxa, for the As-Salam Center. They're looking to collect. Not in this year, but in the upcoming year, inshallah. But do whatever you can, and inshallah, Azza wa Jal, if other organizations decide to purchase a masjid, we will be there. The last thing, Sadaqatul Fitr, do not delay it until the day of Eid. Whoever tells you that they are paying the donation on the day of Eid, tell them that you are liar. There is no way that Sadaqah will reach the Sufuqara and the day of Eid. And if they tell you that we pay the amount in advance of time, tell them how you know about the amount. Maybe you paid $1,000 and now there's $2,000 of Sadaqah al-Fitr. So what are you going to do with the remaining $1,000 remaining? Do not wait until the day of Eid. Do not walk to the Musalla with the $15 to put it in the donation box. It will never reach the hand of the faqir. Allahumma qabbala, Allahumma fashal. We're not collecting, inshallah, any Sadaqah al-Fitr during the day of Eid. We're not going to laugh at you or lie to you to tell what that we're going to send them. That will, there is no way it could be sent in the day of Eid. There is a donation box right now. You can put your donation in this week and next week, inshallah, and we'll send it. Man, they have the program to send it, and there's many brothers who are sending the money on their own. We can work something out to send the Sadaqah al-Fitr, but do not wait until the day of Eid. It will never receive, it will never reach the hand of the faqir. Wallahu ta'ala. Allahumma qul lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. ربنا لا تدع عنا ذنبا الا غفرته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا مريضا الا شفيته وعافيته ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا
أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا